back to Fox 8 News in the morning. Happy Monday, and thank you for being with us today. It seems every morning we wake up to new developments and more information about the coronavirus outbreak globally. Dr. Robert Salata, who's the director of University Hospital's Roe Green Center for Travel and Medicine and Global Health, joins us live. We thank you for being with us, doctor.
Good morning.
Good morning. So let's talk about what the governor has now issued as far as now saying that all these businesses are closed down. We need to be home and kind of in lockdown. Or how important is it that people listen to the governor, listen to the president, and do this and cooperate?
So thank you for the question. It is important that we adhere to this because it is an epidemiologic principle, meaning it is one of the ways that we can prevent further spread by the social distancing. So the rule of thumb that we use is generally that in the context of transmission, you should be not within a 6-foot radius of a person that may be infected and not in that area for more than 5 minutes. I think that's very important because that's how it's transmitted, through coughing, sneezing, even talking, with regard to the generation of so-called respiratory droplets, which is the major way that this is transmitted to others.
How about touching things? We're all kind of, people are going to the grocery store and the people that are still working. How about door handles, credit cards, when you're handling that stuff? Can we get it that way?
So there has been increasing evidence that this particular virus can exist in the environment for hours, and sometimes even up to 96 hours. And in that way, it could be another source of transmission. So I think we have to be awfully careful about cleaning our surfaces, albeit those wipes and things like that are also in short supply. But as much as we can, we should adhere to those principles as well. There has been recent data, just to end, that mail and other packages, et cetera, are not a source. So I think we need to keep that in mind.
All right, well, you brought up mail. How about our takeout? A lot of people are now picking up pizzas, taking out. How about that food when you get it and you put it on your counter surface in your kitchen? And how about, we don't know if the workers have it or not. Do you feel that the food is safe if we're picking up or having it delivered to our homes?
Right now, we have no evidence of transmission in those ways, but we don't know everything about this virus. And I think that's important. We're learning all the time. But to our knowledge, that's not a prominent way of transmission right now.
Let's talk about these medications right now. We're starting to hear about some medicines that look promising for treating coronavirus. What are your thoughts on that?
So they have to, in my view, be subjected to clinical trials so we know that they're definitively beneficial. The drugs that have come into play, including a drug called remdesivir, which is given intravenously, is now being provided by Gilead. And we have two protocols at university hospitals for moderately severe and severe cases, short of those on a mechanical ventilator. But that's the only way we can determine whether this will work. It's worked in the laboratory. It's worked in animal models. So that's one where there's a great deal of hope. The other new ones that have come into the discussion is an old drug called chloroquine or hydroxychloroquine. The former is used in the past for malaria prevention, and the other is often used in folks with rheumatologic conditions like rheumatoid arthritis and lupus. But that's now been combined in a French study with a drug called azithromycin, a Z-pack, if you will, that many people are familiar with. And the two together decrease viral shedding in many cases to a total of 3 days, and there was improvement in respiratory symptoms. The problem is this was a report of only 20 patients from France, and I think that's very encouraging and it's exciting, but we need more information. The State Board of Pharmacy now has restricted these drugs because there's certainly a significant outcry for this to be provided them, and we don't have at this time any information at all about prevention. So I think with this in mind, we are using them here at university hospitals, but selectively, and I think we need more studies to verify, but it looks really interesting and exciting so far.
Good. Well, we need some good news at this point. Doctor, we thank you for being with us today and sharing all this great information with our viewers. Stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you.
And you too. Thank you.
Thank you. God bless you. All right.